Thinking aloud. Conversations on the leading edge of knowledge and discovery with psychologist Jeffrey Mishlove.
By bringing in the role of the observer, in other words, saying that we don't know where a particular particle is specifically located until it's been observed, that sort of opened the door for a wide range of theorists to begin to look at the relationship between physics and consciousness.
Absolutely, definitely. Now, I'm going to dispute that in a while, but there was definitely, because of the fact that the theory just seemed to tell you what you were going to get probabilistically when you do an observation, and people weren't sure what it is that constitutes an observation or measurement. Mm-hmm. All they knew was that the system seemed to be described by these strange objects that we are having trouble visualizing. But we do know that when we make an experiment, we see a particle, or we think we see a determinate result, instead of this whole list of things that might happen. So that became, that's what made people think that perhaps their observation has some crucial role to play.
In other words, quantum mechanics is based on, as we just said earlier, probability clouds.
Right,
or Schrodinger psi waves is another way to look at that.
Yeah.
And but actually, when you observe, when you make an observation, you don't see a probability cloud. You see a particle, or you measure a field.
You measure what tells you a position of where a particle went, or perhaps a momentum, or you see an interference pattern. But you definitely, if you're going to measure a cat, you always find it's either alive or dead. Hopefully not dead.
Well,
but
of course, that's an experiment that's never
that's
really
right.
been
that's
done.
That's right. That's only a thought experiment, and
for
it actually
all
wouldn't
you cat
work.
Lovers out there.
And I explain in my book why that would never happen anyway.
Yeah.
So. Yeah.
But the notion is that something happens where the equations, the probability equations, seem to overall, on a statistical sense, they work out accurately. But any given observation, well, it's just like throwing a dice. You will get an answer, and each die comes up approximately 1/6 of the of the time. But you never know in any given instance until you actually throw the die and look at it what side is going to be face up.
Right.
And quantum mechanics works much that way.
Right. In principle, it cannot tell you, although the Bohmians might say it can. They say that's where the corpuscle is, and that's what tells you why you got that outcome.
Now, there is something called the hidden variable theory. Is that what the Bohmians?
That is a form of a hidden variable theory,
In other words, if only we knew what these hidden variables were, everything would be deterministic.
Right, exactly. And so technically, according to those theories, everything is deterministic. Mm-hmm. And the only thing that appears to give rise to probabilities is our ignorance.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so it's like an ignorance-based probability.